Hello and welcome to this session. Until now, we have seen the features of Kubernetes and we have also learned the basic architecture of Kubernetes. Now it's time that we actually start using Kubernetes, and we have multiple options to install and use Kubernetes. You can set up and install Kubernetes on your personal computer or laptop. You can also set up Kubernetes on a physical or a virtual machine or servers, or you can use Kubernetes as a cloud service. Now, just in case you do not want to do any installation on your systems or any systems and still want to use Kubernetes, we can do that. So there are a lot of online labs available that we can start using Kubernetes even without installing on the system. So in this session, we are going to see all these different ways of using Kubernetes. So let's get started. I'm Raghav. I'm a teacher, and you can find all my work on my website automationstepbystep.com. In this session, we are going to understand and learn the different options to use Kubernetes. Now, here we have three basic ways where you can use Kubernetes. The first one is online Kubernetes labs. These are some online playgrounds and labs that have everything set up. You just have to go to that particular browser or URL on your browser and you can start using it. We will see some options. Then we have Kubernetes installation tools and then cloud-based Kubernetes services. So if we start with online Kubernetes labs, we have Kubernetes Playground. If I go to Google and search for Kubernetes Playground, so here we have this playground from Katekoda. If I go here, you will see a Kubernetes online lab, and you can see here we have one of the labs, which is a beginner lab, and here you can see the difficulty level, the estimated times and all the details. You can start this, and you can see now here we have a master node and a worker node. So everything is set up and installed. You just have to use these commands and you can use Kubernetes. So you can also click here and you can see it is running here, and so you can continue learning and using Kubernetes like this. And this is from Katekoda. So if I go to this website, so you can see we have so many labs for Kubernetes. So all this is available. You can use them and you can learn Kubernetes without even installing on your system. The second option we have is Play with K8s. If I again go to Google and search for Play with K8s, again this is an online lab, so this is the link. If I go to this link, Play with K8s or Play with Kubernetes, this is from Docker, and for the first time you might have to log in with your GitHub or your Docker credentials and then you can start it. So here you will see you can add a new instance here, and here we have got a new instance. You can see the CPU memory and all the details here, and then we also have these commands that you can use. So you can just copy the commands. So if you scroll down, you can see here you can use the commands and you can work with Kubernetes here. So this is another way, and we will see this in detail in the coming sessions. We have Play with Kubernetes Classroom as well. So if I go to Google and search for Play with Kubernetes Classroom, so here is the link, and if I go to this website, here again this is from Docker. So this is Kubernetes hands-on workshop. You can go here and you can play with Kubernetes and use Kubernetes without installing on your system. So you can see all the details are given here. You can see the notes here, and then you have all the commands that you can run from here. So you can start using Kubernetes here. So these are some very good options that you can start with Kubernetes and use Kubernetes even without installing. Then we have Kubernetes installation tools, and here we have MiniCube and CubeAdmin. Now MiniCube is a very quick way to install Kubernetes on your system, especially if you have limited resources. MiniCube will be very ideal to install and set up Kubernetes on the system. Here we will be using a single system for master as well as the worker node. So on the same system, it will have a master instance and a worker instance. So if I go to Google and search for MiniCube, so if I go to this link, installing Kubernetes with MiniCube, this is from Kubernetes documentation. And here you can see it says MiniCube is a tool that makes it easy to run Kubernetes locally for users looking to try out Kubernetes or develop it day to day. So this will be very quick and easy. I will have a separate session on this. And then we have CubeADM. So if I go to Google and search for CubeADM, so let me go to this link, and here it says CubeADM helps you to bootstrap a minimum viable Kubernetes cluster that conforms best practices. And you can install CubeADM on various types of machines, laptops, servers, Raspberry Pi, etc. So again, we will look into CubeADM as well. So these are the common tools that you can use for installing and setting up Kubernetes. Then we have some cloud-based Kubernetes services like Google Kubernetes Engine. Now here we have all the infrastructure available on the cloud. You just have to provide the number of nodes you want and their CPU and memory, and they will spin up all the required infrastructure for you. Similarly, we have a service from Azure, that is Azure Kubernetes Services, and then we have Amazon AKS. So all these services are available on the cloud. They have the entire infrastructure. You just have to provide your number of nodes and CPU and memory, and they will create the entire cluster for you. So we will see some of them in detail, and these are the different options that you can start using Kubernetes, and you can also install on your system and start using it. Now in the coming sessions, we will have hands-on with some of the Kubernetes online labs options so that you know how exactly we can use Kubernetes. I hope this session was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.